Yes, and Shadow, my friends, welcome back to the channel. Today, I want to talk to you about a supplement called Astaxanthin. Several years ago, I was at the store looking at eye supplements, and I found one that has Astaxanthin as an ingredient. And I was like, I'm an eye doctor. I've never heard of this. I should probably know about it. So I dug into the research and found out that Astaxanthin has the potential to protect against several different eye diseases. And that's what I want to talk to you about today. So whether you are struggling with dry eyes, you're worried about cataracts, or you're tired of having eye strain from staring at the computer all day, astaxanthin may be able to help with that. Okay, so first, what is astaxanthin? Astaxanthin is a red carotenoid pigment that's frequently found in marine sources, things like microalgae, as well as salmon and shrimp. In fact, this is the reason why salmon and shrimp even have that pink color to begin with. Astaxanthin is also known to have very potent antioxidant capabilities, as well as anti-inflammatory and anti-apoptotic effects. And if you've never heard of apoptosis before, that is programmed cell death. So that's why it's being researched for not only treatments for metabolic disease, for aging, and even for cancer research. First, let's talk about astaxanthin and dry eyes. Fortunately, several of these studies are showing that astaxanthin can reduce inflammation and oxidative stress on the ocular surface and improve tear film production as well as stabilize the tear film. I found two studies on this, one of which had astaxanthin at a pretty high dose combined with several other eye supplements, and they showed that the participants had improved dry eye symptoms in as early as 8 weeks. And then in a more recent study, while it was just a prospective study with no control group, looked at a moderate dosage of astaxanthin in isolation and showed improvements in not only symptoms, but also clinical signs in just 4 weeks. Now, while these studies are not super robust, the fact that it has such strong antioxidant capabilities in helping with inflammation, I think that shows promise, especially for history of severe dry eye and corneal healing issues. And if it helps people produce more tears and stabilizes the tear film, even better. Now, what about cataracts? Because cataracts is one of the leading causes of blindness worldwide, and astaxanthin is known as a very potent antioxidant. And oxidative stress is one of the known causative factors for lens protein aggregation, which is a key factor for the development of cataracts. Again, I was only able to find a couple of studies on this, and while, yes, the studies were only done in animals, I still think it was rather interesting. They reported that when cataracts were induced, either by given steroid medications or from diabetes, supplementation of astaxanthin did show effective slowing down and prevention of cataract formation in these scenarios, which does suggest that it could be possible that astaxanthin could help prevent the formation of a cataract. Of course, I would like to see more research on this, especially in humans, but it would be a pretty difficult study to track someone taking astaxanthin over a very long time to show that astaxanthin can prevent like age-related cataract formation. But again, at least in these scenarios, it gives some hope. And then probably the best research I've seen on astaxanthin, in fact, is with helping reduce eye strain. In fact, that was what the original supplement I saw at the store was basically advertising it be used for. It was to help with eye strain. Now, the research is showing that astaxanthin can not only help with the oxidative stress, but also helping with improved blood flow, specifically to the muscle inside of the eye called the ciliary body, which helps with accommodation, which is the ability to flex and focus on a near object and then the distance and back and forth. And there's some research supporting that taking astaxanthin can also improve hand-eye coordination after using something like a computer for several hours. And in addition to all this research, there are some publications also suggesting astaxanthin may help with retinal health like macular degeneration and diabetes, and potentially glaucoma as well. Let's talk about dosage for a moment. In these research studies, I've seen it go anywhere from 2 milligrams all the way up to 20 milligrams in these supplement formulations, but on average, it's usually somewhere between 4 and 12 milligrams per day. But from a frame of reference, if somebody wants to like just get it normally in their diet, a 300 gram fillet of salmon has an equivalent of about 6 milligrams of astaxanthin every day. Now, for my own summary and conclusions, after reading all of the research, it seems that astaxanthin does have the capacity to be a very strong antioxidant and have an anti-inflammatory role within the eye. I love seeing that it can improve blood flow, because blood flow affects not just our eye strain, but it affects the retina in the back of the eye. It can affect glaucoma and the optic nerve as well. I think I would love to see more research on all of these subjects, especially done on humans. I think it may take some time before we see more clinical research showing true benefits of taking astaxanthin. But for me personally, because I've struggled with dry eye and I struggle with eye strain all the time, staring at computer screens basically for a living, I have chosen to start taking astaxanthin as a supplement. I take about 12 milligrams every day or every other day. I do personally take that alongside several other vitamins and supplements. And if you want to know more about which ones I do take and why, then definitely check out one of my future videos I'll be coming up with, just about all of the supplements that I take for my dry eye and my overall eye health routine. But of course, before you start taking any supplements on your own, definitely consult your eye doctor as well as your family doctor to hear what they think about all of those different supplements and what research they've read about it. But if you did enjoy today's video and learned something new, please hit that like button for me and leave me a comment below of your favorite part of the video, or if you have any other questions about any specific eye vitamin supplements, things that you've seen or heard about. Otherwise, to catch the next videos on other vitamins and supplements for the eye, you can check out our videos coming up here to the side. Thank you so much for being here. Keep an eye on it, and we'll see you in that next video.